doing a spelt bake, so the first thing we're going to be doing is he's oiling the pan, so we're going to be rolling out the equivalent of about 50 loaves of spelt bread, but it's a number of different varieties. We're going to be doing the four-seed spelt, we're going to be doing sesame honey, we're going to be doing some cinnamon date, and also a couple of varieties of the focaccia loaves. So maybe jalapeno cheese and sun-dried tomatoes, something like that. Kind of depends how we feel when we get to the end. Amazing to think that most of this stuff is done by machines and factories.
So what's the difference by you doing it all by hand compared to what's being done all by machines?
Well, it's going to be kind of a funny answer because I think the difference is the energy in the bread. I mean, that's what some people call it. They say there's no love. Machine doesn't put any love in it. So it's the same every single time. There's no character. There's no variety. It's just this uniform thing that, in my opinion, doesn't really sustain much life. I mean, it gives your body energy. I've worked at lots of restaurants and things in the past, and I never one time heard anybody say, I can taste the love in this food. But it's actually not that uncommon that people. What we use for the bread is we stick with an organic whole spelt flour. And we will cut it with some organic white spelt, which is a little bit lighter, but just to help the rise. But we get our grain from a farmer in Manitoba, Swan Lake. And that's the backbone of the bread. I mean, other than that, we use honey, we use sunflower oil because canola oil has been so tampered with, modified. Organic free-range eggs and yeast helps us all. That's why we do a lot of what we do with the ingredients, is because we've learned what's good. Like the spelt. There's a whole epidemic now. People can't eat wheat, scared of wheat and everything. And it's just because it's been tampered with so much that the body doesn't recognize it anymore. Whereas spelt still exists in its original form. You can get spelt. They found spelt in the pyramids 2,000 years old or whatever, unchanged. The same genetic profile, same gluten level, same everything. So it's a berry that a lot of our ancestors would have been very familiar with. Middle Eastern anyways. We have a little store and bakery, and we're right next door to a deli that we run called the Yellow Deli, which isn't a deli in the sense that we're used to. We're not selling sliced meats and cheeses, but we are making fresh sandwiches, soups, and salads, all to order. Very fresh, very basic, wholesome ingredients, and it's meeting with a good response from the people here in Chilliwack.